Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Rashi. Now this video could look a little off to you guys because I know that my lips are not matching to what I say. We had a little technical issue. The video was recorded mute, the mics weren't working, the battery was off. So I'm gonna leave all that aside and I'm still gonna give a voiceover because this look came out so good that I didn't want it to miss sharing it with you. So before that, subscribe to my channel, hit the like button. Find me on Instagram, Rashi Sopti Makeup, and now let's start this look. Today I'm going to be creating the matte eyes that we just showed. They are done with just about two shades, the brown and orange. I'm starting with the primer. I have taken Forever 52's Elixir. It's a very light primer, guys. It's perfect for daily use. I have now used an orange corrector and I'm using it around my pigmented area, which is my mouth, and a little under my eyes. And then we just need to blend it, just dab it well, just make sure the skin is kind of absorbing it well. Oh my god, this is a little funny watching myself talking something else and you guys are listening something else. Okay, so I've taken the caramel shade from Maybelline Age Rewind and I'm applying it all over the area that I had corrected. Dab, dab, dab. Here I've taken the sand shade from Maybelline Age Rewind again. What I'm doing here is I'm actually doing the contour and the highlighting, the liquid highlighting and liquid contour before the foundation because that's going to give us a natural effect, a natural contour. So I don't know if you guys can really make out the difference, but I really could, off camera. So I hope this technique can kind of helps you if you're not looking for something very strong on your face. So now you've seen I've plotted all the contour and highlight on my face. It is very important that you merge these two beautifully, guys. Just dab them to the area that they have been deposited. And that should give us a good canvas to place our foundation on. Now moving on to my foundation. This is one of my favorites, Maybelline Fit Me foundations. I'm on the shade Natural Buff 230 in case we both have the same colors, but a very light consistency again, and it's not going to overlap the contouring that we've done before. So it's gonna, that contouring and highlight is going to come through this foundation. I'm going to bake today, so I've taken the Makeup Revolution banana powder. I'm placing it under my eyes and I'm just going to keep it for 5 to 10 minutes because I don't want my face, my under eyes to become too dry. And applying the rest on the face so that the base sets. For my brows, I've taken the Cup Brow from Benefit India. And again, guys, it's one of the best pigments that you can use for creating very sharp brows. Now that my brows are done, I'm getting rid of the excess powder. Like I said, if I keep it for too long, it is going to show, it's going to get very dry. So you just make sure 5 minutes are actually good enough to bake. I'm taking a brown shade now, and this is Cypress Umber from Soft Glam. You can use any brown that you have. How dark, how light you want it to be is your choice. But to get this kind of look, you must use a dark brown. I'm placing it all over my lid and not really crossing my crease. So if you see, that's the coverage that I have done. That's how dark I want it to be. And that's the only area that we're going to stick to. I'm using this beautiful palette by Beauty Glaze, which I showed you in my last video as well. So I'm going to mix these two shades of orange to get my perfect orange that I want. And now I am depositing that on the crease line. And I'm going to merge it with my lid color. So these are the only two shades that we're playing with. But this needs years of blending, guys. You have to blend these two shades. I mean, as much time as you can take to get that perfect blending, guys, please give it. That same brown, I'm placing it under my lower lashes as well. This is going to make my eyes look bigger and complete the look. I've taken that orange again, and then again I'm merging it under my lashes again. And just to give a dark sense to my look, I am actually for a change applying kajal today, both on my lower waterline and my upper waterline. You cannot skip the mascara, and after this I'm going to apply my false lashes. Mission accomplished. I am moving towards my contouring. Now, if you saw, there was already some kind of light contouring that was coming through that we've done before. I'm using my NYX bronzer, to just deepen that contouring all the more. But I'm not going to overdo it, guys. That forehead, that nose, that jawline. Make sure you've contoured everything that you think is bigger and you want to give an illusion of something smaller. My highlighter today is MAC Soft and Gentle, and I know I was giving a tip here which obviously is missed, but I'll give it to you in the next video. So recently I've realized that I'm a blush person. I'm an absolute blush girl. If you see, I take my blush to another level. I'm using Coral by Bobbi Brown today, and again there's going to be ample amount of it on my face. I'm just going to apply the lipstick by MAC Cosmetics. It's in the shade Chili. It's like a rustic orange. I found it a little too bright for this look, otherwise it's a beautiful shade. I'm going to just dab some nudist shade by L'Oreal Infallible, and it's just going to bring the whole lipstick shade a little down, just the way I wanted it to be. I'm just going to finish this look with my makeup spray, and that's matte eyes for you. So guys, if you see, these eyes have drama. They're dark. They can be glamorous, and glamorous without any glitter or shimmer. They're absolutely matte. What did you think about this look? Tell me in the comment section below. Subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell icon because you want to know about the next video soon. And find me on Instagram, Rashi Soapthi Makeup. I'm going to see you very, very soon. Bye.